Alright, so the point of this video is to further explain how I broke out the novation synth. I keep hearing that it sounds brittle and it doesn't sound that tough. My idea was to treat it more akin to a synth with a controller as opposed to tweaking presets. So what I've done is I've created a little template for myself, which is essentially a blank. On here, I previously mapped ADSR onto these four knobs, and I've still got, this will scan the first oscillator's wave. This will choose the first oscillator's wave. If it's a wavetable, this knob will scan through its position. This is the second oscillator wave shape. This will again scan through the second one's position. And I had ADSR mapped to this. I've recently changed these and a couple of other things. So I realised that I'm not using attack so much, and I am not using sustain so much. So I've mapped this one to detune the first oscillator from the second, and this one to detune the second oscillator from the first. I've also set on here this to change the semitones of the second oscillator, so you can either use it like a sub, or you can to beef it up, or you can use it on the same octave and detune it. So I'll just quickly go over those basic things for now, and then we'll go from there. So we'll stick to one oscillator. We'll have a saw. We'll leave it there. Get the second oscillator. Just make sure everything's set correctly. Second oscillator. That's the first one. Bring it in the second one. The second oscillator will scan through. Now the way I've set these two knobs up is they will detune from each other, so now you can get a nice warm sound without relying on effects yet. So I've still got this one to release if you needed it. But if it's on zero, like a mono synth. Again, detuning. Okay, now again, this is said to be quite brittle, this synth. Black bass. So one of the things I've done is, as I said, I've put drive for the pre-distortion on clipper, and it's on full, and I leave that there just to give it a bit more warmth, the sound, before I do anything else to it. Then set post distortion as well, and I'll show you why. If you get the envelope and you create that lovely stabby sound, let's just change it a bit. That's nice, and then you distort it. Sounds so boring. Got a bit more bite to it. Right, okay, so beyond that, there's the first one, which changes the octave of the second oscillator. But you can also do sevenths, so it will go up a whole octave, so you can do anywhere in between. Let's leave it there for now. Also got chorus, or sorry, let's oscillate the tune a little bit, and then. Obviously with chorus and oscillated D tune, they both sound too similar, so at least you can pick which one you want. And then finally, it's V-Sync. All of this sounds really complicated, but it's not really, it's just setting the CCs, and once you've done it, this feels more akin to a synth now, and I'll show you quickly. If I was to make a bass sound, this also works really well for chords. So let's make sure we've got a preset. Now one thing I'm going to have to do is get the tracks to hold it here. So you notice how quickly I was able to record that in as well and not have to think about anything too much. And there's the tracks dropping notes. It still sounds good though. So as long as the release is held down, you won't get notes overlapping. If you are to play a single note that you want release on, still works. I haven't really seen a downside to this really. It makes it feel more like a synth. It makes it a bit more tougher, a bit more grittier, and a bit easier to get to where you're going. Using the presets, I always seem to get stuck. I'm not sure what the knob's doing. This will be a template that I'll keep for a long time. Evidently use. It's helping me with my tracks big time. I've already got other synthesizers, and this makes it more akin to those. That's all I wanted to say. Thanks for your time, and hopefully I'll do more. Like and subscribe.